smell. Let me just like say that the fridge we had was like this old 30-year-old fridge, and it was just locked tight. It was an amazing fridge. But as soon as you like look in the fridge and you look at the milk, and the milk is just like literally the worst one we had was we had this 2-liter carton of milk. And in the 2-liter carton of milk, there was a probably 2 or 3 inch thick chunk of obviously like separated curds and whey kind of crap, right? Just floating in all of the whey water stuff. And it was like basically a solid lump of cheese was growing in there, is my assumption. But the container itself had expanded to the point where we weren't even sure if we were going to be able to pick it up to safely remove it from the building because it was just on such an explosion like situation. Okay, we're getting hunted by lynxes. That's not good. It's a lot. 38 of them. Alright, well, I have a caravan out that's waiting to go too. Not really keen on this. We get a few people ready to go. They should get attacked. Like, down here doesn't have a lot, but I should be able to get some. I can get you guys hanging down here near the things. I might be able to get them to turn suddenly. Yeah, so this fucking milk. I, of course, was the one that decided to remove it from the fridge because everybody else was being a chicken shit about it. And I'm like, look, you can't just leave it in there until it does eventually explode. Like, you actually have to remove it. And so I ended up getting it and, like, really, really carefully, like, pulling it out and supporting it underneath and holding it up and all that sort of stuff. Making sure I was doing the best I possibly could given the situation. I feel like you guys kind of, like, un-fucking soldiered. Anywho, it doesn't matter. If they go on their quest, that's great. So I just want to finish this before this raid happens. I got it up until about halfway through the store, which was still, thank God, on tiles. And it went. It exploded. And, of course, that covered me. And actually, I was right next to where my desk was in the building as well. So that covered my desk, chair, the walls, some of the produce, like some of the stuff we sold. And what I remember is that some of the staff were like literally standing outside the front door, holding the door open for me. And they were just like, as soon as they got a smell of it, they ran halfway through the car park. And we're like trying not to vomit. And I was covered in the stuff. And I'm like, great. This is just fucking fantastic. So, yeah, I was in one of those companies where there was shit about a lot of things. So not only did I have to like clean all that up while smelling like pure vomit, I also had to continue to work for a while in that because they would not let me leave. And on top of that, we had customers come in and automatically leave because it smelled so fucking awful. Yeah, not a good place. It took about 2 weeks to stop smelling like that, by the way. Sam, get out of there. They're like really going up high. I think they're trying to follow Franklin. Look, if I can get you guys down here, that's great. Franklin, you just go inside there, yeah? The rest of you lot, I really need you guys to run backwards. I need them to come further down here. I know you guys are hauling your animals, but trust me on this one, you're gonna want to move. Okay. I think Franklin will be... yeah, as soon as he went inside, they're starting to... stay inside, mate. Stay inside. If I can get them to come down here, Sam is so slow. You guys are going to have to duck inside. Gabriella, the fuck are you doing? Look, you guys come and huddle down here. Chris, mate. Chris, I don't think you're going to make it. Do you guys... you guys might be better off just running up and in there. They might be able to make it up in there. I don't know. You lot, what the fuck is going on here? They're killing my guinea pigs. It's melee attacking a lynx. Right. Guys can't get anywhere from there. These fuckers are gonna... Of course they can come through these, can't they? Forgot about that. Your best bet would be to see if you can get in there. Because if you can, you're safe. If you can't, you're not. And I think I could probably sneak these guys down here now. And guinea pigs died. That's not too tragic. These guys are going to go down hard, though. Oh, rare thrombos. Limmy, the fuck are you doing? I'm hoping she doesn't get it ass-handed to her too badly. Like, she might actually die. I was hoping to just lure them down here, but everybody being spaced out where they were, it's just not listening. And you guys, move back. This is so fucking awful. I know if I roll it back, I won't have any thrombos though. Not that I'm worried about that. Alright. So this has been sufficiently shit. Let's have a look at how bad people hurt. You've got 4 hours. You're probably not going to make it back to a hospital. That guy's getting rescued. You got 4 hours, 5 hours. Any one of these guys are less than four. Like 4 hours is too far to get from here to the hospital and treated. So I'm gonna save this as a Asora too. And I'm going to try to load up the raid again and see if I can just fix him up. Yeah, you're right, Grim. When you're handling, like, milk that's expired, you've got to be really careful with it. I'd say, like, probably the best thing to do would be, if it's possible, is to see if you can, like, get a bit of glad wrap carefully around the opening of it while you're still in the fridge. So you're not, like, moving it out into a different space temperature kind of thing. All right, since you lot are the problem... They went for Franklin pretty much straight away. And I don't know if this has got animal flaps on it. I would say get in here. And the one's up here. I'm still going to send you guys down here. But I'm going to do it in a way. You guys could probably go... Okay, you guys are too far away up here. These ones. Lincoln can probably just get inside. I know that if they go anywhere near certain animals, they're gonna, I mean, certain like machinery and stuff, they're gonna be fucked. I'm just thinking if I can come in here. In there. People gather over here, survive it. No, the problem I forgot was there were a few people that were really high up. Like, I didn't realize I had Lumi coming all the way down. So, with her fucking around with that, and there was a couple of people, like, they were chasing Franklin. So, if I take that option away from them by throwing people inside, immediately there's not much they can do about it. Now, that should take everybody more or less inside. Once they're inside, these turrets should work. The problem that I also had was the fact that I put them where animal flaps exist. And animal flaps allow any animal, be it good or attacking, to be able to access. Okay, you guys are almost all inside. You guys are inside. Okay, Cypress, for the love of fuck, stay where you are. Okay, by the look of it, I think everybody is inside. I'm not too sure who they're going for or what they're going for. It looked like they were going for somebody up here and I think they've just realized, oh shit. Okay, well that is a problem. Okay, how's about you guys move into there quickly instead? Of course, one of my cats has decided to go through it. Yeah, that ain't gonna fly. All right, let's see if I can throw the cats into the raid zone so that they just don't let them into my house. it really is surprising how much, like, this usually isn't a problem, but they're really, like, pressing to make it a problem. Okay, everybody down here, get your asses in there. You stay in there. You guys get in there. You guys should be good to go in there. You can stay where you are. You can get into here. Pretty much most of you guys are out here should be fine to get somewhere. All right. I think everybody will be inside then. Yeah, okay. Animals. I didn't think I had to set you guys to raid, but apparently I fucking do. Let's see, the panthers. Now, they should be where people are, but I'm not necessarily saying that they will be. Okay, let's get you guys all to run into raid. Not the guinea pigs. I couldn't give two fucks about the guinea pigs. They can stay where they are. I have a male thrombo calf, and the cats can get into raid. Alright. The big thrombos should be fine. They'll probably go roughly where the people are, and same with these will go where the people are. You open doors for intruders. Yeah, well, I generally am fine so long as they don't kill, you know, the specific animal that I'm trying to save, like a main animal or something. But if I get everybody inside, the cats stop walking out between fucking rooms. So all the animals should race to where they've got to be. You're heading inside too. Yep. Okay, they're all inside. What is this cat doing? Cat one. The fuck you doing, mate? Part of that. Where's cat one? Why are you just wandering? I thought you'd be going to somewhere that's like a raid zone. Don't tell me they're gonna like go between the fucking rooms. They so are, aren't they? You guys should stay in here. Great. How's about you don't do that? Okay. Should be able to get them out of here. Probably up into there. Theoretically without getting attacked, if that or even this room. Although there's a fucking cat walking into it, so maybe not the best idea. I could probably get him into this room safely from the distance of that. With that cat opening up that door, I don't know if they're going to attack them. They shouldn't, but I assume that they should go for wherever people are. Okay, that's safe. Now I should be able to at least get you guys over here. I don't need to, but I figure if I can get them all grouped together, if the cats are going to fuck around doing stuff, I might as well have a group of people. You guys, like, for real, Silverware is currently down. There's nothing she can do to protect herself. Are there any up this side? Because if I can slip them up into here too. Because of these fucking cats leaving the doors open. Oh shit, they're attacking that door. Oh, now that is actually a problem. Okay. Let's put our gunners where we can put them. I don't know. Well, you're not going to stand there, are you? Cool. All right. I kind of need my melee people to be up front. And for you to probably go there and fuck off. Stop everything you're doing, you piece of shit. You can go stand there. I'll move my gunners up here. We have a fair chance that that opens. It's not going to be a fair chance because there's not a lot of people there. I think that's going to be the one spot where we've got a problem. All right. I'm kind of hoping that they get shot by turrets, honestly. More than anything. People are going to have like mental breakdowns and all sorts of stuff and start moving around soon. I'm going to try to sneak you over into, say, this room over here. Because what's going to happen is when I move you, they're going to go for that area. Dude, the fuck you doing? Honestly, you can go down. I don't really care. Cool. 12 hours. That's still a pretty good amount of time. Now, if I can have a cat avoid opening a single fucking door in this place, like, how's about, like, don't allow? Yeah? That's good. Nobody's fucking opening doors. This cat can go back where it thought it was going. Yeah, there we go. They're going out this way now. Still worry about this collection here that's very concerning. They're going out and they're getting attacked. I'm thinking the only way I could possibly attract them out that way is if I got somebody to go outside. And this guy's pretty close over here. So if I brought you outside, apart from the fact that that thing's being attacked. How hard are these things to kill at the moment? They've got 6 hours. Alright, let's stand somebody outside and see if I can bring that whole cluster of fuck over here. These ones should be pretty interested in where he is too. Alright, he's outside. They're actually not coming over. Oh, okay. Dude, what are you doing? You're going to rest, are you? Radio. If that's the case... Yeah, you're not going to help him. Just try to get up in here if that's it. You! Can you not fucking walk? Oh, of course the fucking doors are not allowed. Go up in here. I don't really have a reason to not attack him, but what I was trying to do is limit how many were going to attack me at one time. And since they're not going to come out of there, this guy's down again. I'm going to have to bring you guys all out as a group. Alright. Lumi can bring her panthers down here too. You guys can actually move out of the room, please. Not bringing them over. I kind of wanted to take him through a chokehold spot. I'm not going to get that opportunity. Now, you're not the pacifist. One of you are. Where is Amir? Go rescue him. May or may not get attacked by that one. So here we go. Also, all the animals can attack too. Okay. Keep moving through. Just move as a solid block, please. Come down here. And an Amir, take him to a fucking... Put him in there. There you go. Should bring him in nicely. Amir, if you can, like, yeah, look, just fucking feed him at the moment. It's not like he's not bleeding out or anything, you know? Okay. I sort of want you guys to fan out a little bit, honestly. This row is probably all doing the shooty stuff. I need some of these guys that are not shooting to move up to front. You are, you're not. Alright, maybe turn your fire off so we don't just kill everything. No, I literally mean, like, stop fucking firing. And come and just melee attack the things. Okay, he's good. Is that all of them? Nearly all of them. We'll just go attack that one. Melee attack it. A few lot at the back, I'm pretty sure, are, like, other. Come on. Go be free. You lot can get out of there. Most unusual way I've had to, like, survive something like that. Nobody else is up here. Just this group down here. The only reason why I was trying to avoid it was I was trying to get the use of the turrets since I have them. I'm like, I might be able to limit casualties and stuff. I'm still pretty sure some of the people that are going on a caravan are still hurt. Virus mechanites. You still got 7 hours. I'm pretty sure Army can be doing something else now. Oh, she's tending to him. Fine. Well, that did result in, honestly, less death. They are all being hunted. Other ones can get hunted too. How are the animals? Some of these guys got fucking shot by my people. Mark's in a daze. He's fine though. Any of the other animals hurt? Is this guy being tended to? He is. Alright, this one's got death in... Nope, no more death. This one's got 10 hours, so keep an eye on that one. All in all, considering how little damage everybody actually took, it's really not that bad. I haven't really tried the path of avoidance much. Like, really only since I've been streaming. Like, beforehand, I'd only just take them on and be like, everybody can shoot. It's fine. But I'm like, I just wanted to try to see if I could do it without hurting them. One person's having a mental break. Who's the bastard having a mental break? Markers. Look, Mark. You're carrying shit, aren't you? Of course you are. Means I have to wait till you're done. We should have a psychic soothe to help because everybody be a bit sore. Let's just throw up one of these. Won't do much. At least they don't do much anymore. Yeah, it feels alright. So it'll last for about 24 hours and I'm hoping if I pump another one of those in the next day, maybe I can get them to be less angry to go out. I also can't wait for some fucking grass to grow as well. And Ginseng's now having a tantrum. You're not part of the thing, so that's fine. Alright, well that was a heap of food that came in. And I'm pretty sure I've got... Let's have a look at what these make. Simple meals and pemmican. Vegetarian and carnival meals. Don't have any real vegetarian meals, but we've got a fair bit of meat. I know that they'll make plenty of stuff over time as I have more things here. I'm just hoping that I've got enough beds finally for them. Nobody's using that. Nobody's using that. I should have, honestly, more beds than I have people. Somebody's got an infection. Cat does. That's fine. Yeah, so, did these things give off panther leather? Is that what they do? Oh, interesting. I guess it's like panthera is more like it's a cat species, big cat species coat is the leather that it gives. I should be able to get rid of little fireplaces too, so just scroll out and see if I can get majority of these toggle off. The ones down here can toggle off. Go. Alright, how bad is this feed pen anyway? Oh shit, we have nutrition equal for it. I do like the fact that sometimes it will tell you, like, for how many animals, the total consumption and stuff like that. It doesn't show for cows, so I'm guessing cows eat something else. Either way, I guess there's nothing up in here at the moment, so this pen's going to actually do some good. How is this for, like, refrigerating? -9 degrees. If these stay refrigerated over summer, this area is going to end up with so much rice in it. All of my animals are fucking everywhere. What happened? Did you guys break another one of these again? Of course you did. Alright, well, let's send down somebody. You're gonna beat the fire out. How about you cut down some trees? So, yeah, you can't. You're taking kibble to them. Look, you could drop that right there. Yeah, you can drop that right there. Cut a bunch of trees down instead of beating that out, because let's be honest, this is all going to break anyway. A couple of them can come up here and see if we can, like, maybe save the fence from burning completely. If I can save that from going. And we've got some trees cut down. They might be able to maybe start rebuilding. How do you work on that? Red, can you prioritize beating out the fucking thing? Nina? Cool. Pretty sure... Oh, that's right, the power's down from that. I can wait. Animals wandering away, is it? A chicken's going at lightning speed. I don't know if we'll ever catch it. Anyway. They will hopefully get that fucking built because I actually cut some friggin' logs. Let's see, what are you doing? Can you build? There's a couple of people building at least. I was wondering why she was so slow. I'm like, she doesn't have anything missing. She's just got, like, her legs injured. It's fine. It's going to be hard for them to find all the fucking animals to make this caravan, honestly. Is everybody... Mark's still having his friggin' mental break. Not even sure why he was having a mental break. And my cows are on the outside now. Not like they're really getting to anything great, honestly. Don't have wood. Yeah, let's get a team of people down here and fix that fucking problem. You can't do it. Look, I know you're training somebody, but you're not forming a caravan. Hey, son. Yes, I'm well aware of them slowly getting away, but if you guys were actually down here cutting some fucking trees, we wouldn't even be having this problem. All right. Nina's having a food binge because she's being useless. Speed this shit up, huh? Once we've got a couple of logs here, I can at least trust Tofu to, like, construct shit properly. There we go. I'm sure you've got the bio for construction. Maybe you want to, like, finish that before you fuck off? Like, seriously, I'm going to make you finish this. Each one is like one click. One fucking click. There. Fence is done. I swear these people sometimes. I click on the eggs, goddammit. All these eggs, I feel like they're like... They could be fertile, they could be ripe, but they could also be just rotted. I kind of want to make a spot where these egg boxes will go. But I know that the eggs are just going to keep getting, like, moved to them. I reckon I might just make a spot for that at the moment. Probably about yay long. This can have... What I'm looking at is the fact that all these have eggs in them and some of them are ruined from winter. So I just want to kind of get, see, is it, it's not an animal bed. What is these things called? Wooden egg box. All right, hold on. Yeah, my theory is that it might be, they may be holding on to rotten ones as is. I don't want to deconstruct them. I just want to lift them. If they can go to here, that'd be great. Because anything that's unfertile will go up to get cooked. Anything that is fertile will sit here. And if it's good to go, it'll hatch in a week. This. Yeah, see, it says ruined by temperature. Hoping I've got enough space for this. Let's make it a bit longer. Cool. Well, that's going to get rid of some of the eggs that were fucked from winter. Alright. How is this fucking caravan going? Mark, can you stop being a cunt and just get out there? I feel like as soon as I take you off the caravan, somebody else is going to have a mental break for having to wait your fucking sorry ass. Even now, they're still making clothes and stuff. Maybe I could chuck some extra shit on since, you know, they're doing that. Let's see. You're from the caravan. I don't want to do it at night while they're actually sleeping. What I might do is when it comes to morning, I'll get them to load up the extra clothes. Since they're making them, I might as well take them to sell. It's also that too. I'm pretty sure I might have a mixture of day and night people. That could be where I'm getting an issue here. But there is still a couple of parts of the day where they're both awake. I can at least have people loading shit up. As soon as Mark's ready to go, I hope they can find all the fucking animals that are like loose across